We are Legion.
We are all.
We are one.
We are
watching.
Hey folks, welcome back to another fun-filled week of information on the world of digital cards. With me as always, at my side, my loving bride. I gotta make it weird this week. The lovely and the talented, Padme1138, how you doing?
Fabulous.
I had to rhyme ride and side and bride. And
did you?
Good. I felt like I needed to. And with us this week is our special guest, returning fan favorite, and that is MDJacobus. How are you today, sir?
Good. How's everybody doing? Thanks for having me.
Crushing it. I'm in like such a good mood
good
today.
Time.
The weather's been nice and it's getting cool. It feels cold and kind of autumnal.
It's 44 degrees right now. That's
pretty chilly down there.
Yeah,
yeah, I don't like it.
Yeah. It was in the 30s. I took the dog out. It was like 30 something.
It's nice and cool and the
laundry's gonna suck this week.
Well, you don't have to do it. I'm the one.
I gotta fold it and put it up.
Oh, that's true. Yeah. Cool. I just
dump
dirty laundry on the bed. Boom.
Oh.
Well, he folds and takes care of his stuff, but
I'm not allowed to fold hers.
I'm accused of the same thing.
I could never do it right. I'm terrible at that.
Yeah, he doesn't fold it right.
No, I'm accused of the same thing. Oh, you only put your own stuff away. I'm like, I don't know where yours goes. I'm sorry.
Yeah, I'm not in charge of that.
Or he folds the t-shirts different and I don't like it.
Yes, exactly. I do them a certain way and she doesn't like that way. Because I do the snappy, you know, the...
Yeah, I regret showing you that thing.
Oh, yeah. Well, it was words to live by. I've gone with it ever since.
Yeah, you've been doing it for a couple of years.
Yes. So it's been a week in the world of digital cards. A lot of weird stuff going on in all the places. So I guess we can go ahead and get right into it. Tarot cards, not a lot has changed since my nearly hour conversation with Previn yesterday. If you haven't had a chance to check that out, go and listen to it. Previn's a great guy, and he was actually showing us some stuff that's coming for next year, like the new base, and outlining some plans and stuff like that. And you could tell he's had a year. He should be tired. He's had an amazing year so far.
He really has. Last month, even from October on, October was obviously like we always say, is humongous in tarot cards. October was insane. Thanksgiving time, all through November it was nuts. It's still nuts. He's got so many sets going on right now. It's really busy and we still have Hunting Grounds to finish up, so he's got so much content right now. It's really nice.
I like the way that he's doing the Christmas presents this year. Yep. In that you can pick the movie that you want. There's no award for collecting all of them, so really the only incentive is for you to go for the ones that you like. So probably a number of the movies we've seen over the course of the year, we're going to see in as presents. So I thought that was a really nice change because it's kind of a bummer to get something you don't really care about. So you have more of a chance of picking out what you like in that scenario. So I like it. I like what you did with that.
It should be good. I did the first two, of course. I don't know how the second. Well, I didn't.
I threw it a couple of them, then I realized, it's space straight edge kegger. I just don't care about that movie at all. So I'll wait for something I do like. It's fun to remember that last year, at the end of last year, that's when all the Velocipastor stuff came in those Christmas presents.
Yep, that was cool.
End of the year, that's where they had the tooth relic and stuff like that. And we're all just kind of like, what the fuck is this thing? This guy with the dinosaur head. Action figure, what the fuck is this garbage? And then it came out and we're all like, oh my god, it's amazing.
Yeah, pretty awesome.
I would say very awesome. And it was kind of cool to ask him about what was it like kind of being like, you kind of tapped into the zeitgeist there with this Velocipastor deal, where he was previewing it for us at Christmas, and then when it came out and it became this big viral sensation in quarantine,
for sure. We're very lucky to have some of that content ahead of time. That's pretty cool.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it was really cool, and it felt like we were all a part of something before it even really happened. That was neat. That's kind of cool. So we're seldom ahead of the curve here. I'm usually behind a little bit. And he also showed the new base, Which I have in, you know, I show in there and stuff. So you want, if you're curious to see what the new base look like, pretty nice, clean design. Again, you're going to be looking at these cards for a long time, but he says they'll be starting up, you know, as soon as the new year begins, which for him, I know probably means January 1. Boom, here's your new base.
It was, I think last year it was January 1, and then we had the 1 week award to try to collect them all.
Yeah, and I was surprised to see that he's still got base awards on tap for red, white, and blue. The base, you know, like the earliest base that we got way back January 1st, 2020, when we had no idea this year was going to be so fucking bad.
Yeah.
But it's going to, you know, take a while to start gathering. I got to pick a horde again.
And I just started really finally getting all the names straight. Like you said, you make up names in your head of what you see and what you think it is. But now it's like when somebody says, you know, a character or a scene or whatever, that I'm like, oh, I know what that one looks like now, because it's been a year I've been looking at them for that long.
Right.
So it takes a while to get the names of the characters or the base straight.
Some of them I still never have, and I have to look at them. And there's a bunch of them that just seem the same. You know, they're just so similar. So, you know, I mean, the monsters you're gonna remember. You know, you're not gonna forget Demon Shark. Demon Shark. Demon Shark. Demon Shark. I had to go at least that far with that. So, and then so the new base is coming. The next wave of decay should be coming, I think he said, this week. So he's getting really close to the end with that. So there's gonna be awards for decay. There's going to be awards for fire. There's going to be awards for black, which is the big one. That kind of turned into a mini monument last year. I think only
that was cool.
Four or five people finished it.
Yeah, something like that.
It was really low. And then he put the names of everybody who completed it on the back. So it was like a little mini monument, because that's an achievement. There may be more of them this year. I think this year, I think we've seen a much wider cooperation amongst under 10 people that are trying for that. I feel sorry for anybody started late in the year, because you're getting now to the point where you're running out of time for melds. There's not going to be that many more melds. I mean, literally there'd be 20 more days of melds for black. And if there's a card that you're missing and it doesn't pop up on by random in those 20 days, you're fucked. I'm still waiting for the guard from fire to show up again.
I only had one. I saw your post. I only
have one as well. And somebody gave me one. I can't remember who it was. I think it might've been Thomas Otterman that gave it to me. So I have two, I've got two sets of fire set, but it would be nice if that meld would pop up, because I've probably got enough to meld two or three of them. That's going to be one of the lowest count ones in there. Although it's not the lowest count in the bunch right now.
No, I took me a while to get all of mine, but I have at least one set, and I've been melding extras just for fun. Maybe I can balance it at two. That would be
cool. That one should be pretty low. I mean, a lot the fire cards range in count from 30 to 50-ish, I want to say.
Something like that, yeah.
Something like that. So, you know, you'll see a completion rate of maybe 50% on that one, I would think. Yeah. Being able to stack awards is just such a goddamn genius thing.
Yeah.
Seriously. I mean, it's, you know, just avoid so much bullshit to be able to just have, I've got five sets. Boom. Here's five awards. Yep. Enjoy. Congratulations. Enjoy your dumb achievement. over in the world of Neon Mob, they're getting into that holiday spirit. We finished extra wacky packy November. So that's over with. And my pro subscription expired. So I had no regrets until this morning when I saw that Ray Lonsdale has a new Century Limited Christmas set.
Can you renew it now, or is it too late?
No, I don't need to. It's a small set. It's going to be there for 5 months. I threw a bunch of carrots at it. When I was saying, I think last week, I was at like close to 2 million carrots, because when I was pro for 2 months, they kind of accumulate really quickly.
Yeah.
And you get more when you finish sets. And then I was mulching shitloads because I was pulling shitloads. So I threw like a shitload of carrots at the thing this morning. So I'm pretty close. Right. I think I need to pull one more variant, and that'll be good. Not variant chase.
Right. Oh, cool.
And then it's just dupes for needs and stuff. So
yeah, you'll round it out.
I pulled enough to finish, you know, the base set and get in there, get an early finish on it. I don't know when that dropped. I completely missed that drop. But it's not a limited. It goes for 5 months. So.
Right.
They'll be out there. But I've always collected those sets. Ray Lonsdale does a really cool thing with the, it's kind of like a photo pastiche type thing. It's interesting. He's using photography and kind of cramming every, you know, shopping everything together. But they look neat. The way he does the stuff looks really cool. And then there's always a big bunch of text that goes with him and stuff like that. And then Ray Lonsdale's super involved in collecting in the app as well. So you'll be collecting a Ray Lonsdale set and then you'll get a trade from Ray Lonsdale.
That's weird. That's pretty awesome.
Over in the world of blockchain, really haven't seen anything about anything this week. I'm still waiting, I think, to see more details on Alien Quadrilogy. We really haven't gotten a look at what that content actually looks at yet.
Yeah.
Looks like yet. So hopefully we'll see something like that soon.
Yeah.
Over in the fabulous, fantastic world of bunt, kick, slam. I have no idea.
I got nothing because I'm not in those. No idea.
Tim was yelling about something this week. There was some kind of something with.
Oh man, wasn't there a contest or something?
Yeah, it was like the last contest of the year or something like that with MLS, and it was all fucked up and.
Oh, something. I did see on the Discord that Merv was asking Tim questions, you know, about something about how it was going to work or whatever. So yeah, I think there was some kind of contest, but.
Who knows? Yeah, I'm just like so not in that world at all. And most of the sports apps I really haven't been paying a lot of attention to.
I haven't been paying attention
to the point like I know I'm forgetting to open it on days. Like literally go whole days. I try to stay on the ones that still give you the 25K and then the bonus on 7. I try really hard to hit those and make sure that gravy train's rolling. But the work for food, man, I just can't do it.
I don't know. I'm not on. Yeah. Nope. I haven't paid attention to real sports either. Like even football, I barely look at, you know, baseball didn't do anything for me this year and I just don't watch it, you know?
Right. So, yeah. I mean, like the football season itself, we fucking tanked so hard, so fast. Minshew mania flamed out like nobody's business. And I'm probably just a fair weather fan. What else are you going to do when your fucking local team's the Jaguars?
I don't know.
You know, I mean, it's like, no, I'll be there for the good times, but I'm not fucking dragging my ass through the misery.
I'm just glad I didn't like buy a jersey.
Oh, like an expensive Minshew jersey. It'd be a collector's item because so few were produced before he tanked.
I was looking at him and I almost bought a jersey. Luckily, I only bought, you know, like the t-shirts that have the number on it.
Well, I'm glad I didn't get that face tattoo. I was going to get
the mustache. You should have got the
soul patch and then the mustache and just kind of the sunglasses and the headband. Just that right here.
Because he's healthy. His thumb is finally okay.
He's in the penalty box.
He's in the penalty box.
Bad thing.
Starting Glennon again.
Glennon.
Dude looks like an orc.
They had a picture of him like walking around like off the field like at practice or whatever. And he's like, it's funny because he's like kind of like walking towards the camera in slow motion.
Like an orc.
Mike Glennon, you know, like Legends of the Gridiron. And he looks like a fucking orc. He's got ears that stick way out. Oh. And he's not a handsome dude. And I was saying, I was like, you know, probably he's like, yeah, I'm going to be a quarterback. I'm going to get so much pussy.
I'm going to be a quarterback. I'm going to get
so much puss. And then, no. Because you look like a fucking orc, bro.
Hey, he's got a face for radio.
Yeah, he's not a pretty man. He's no Minshew. I'll just say that. So
I got nothing. I got nothing on those apps. I don't know. Like I said, I can't even intelligently talk about sports this year.
No, I hardly have looked at it. No, I did look.
There aren't any intelligent sports this year.
Yeah. No, it's
seriously, Ohio State. They're gonna put Ohio State in the national championship. Then they play like two games or something. Yeah, come on, man.
But they were really good games. Oh, they really showed a lot of strength.
Bullshit.
A lot of power in everything they did in those games.
You know, they're currently thinking that Jaguars are going to take their quarterback
okay.
in the draft.
Who is their quarterback?
Justin Fields.
Okay. I don't know anything.
I don't know. How much did he play this year? He's like, you know, laced up and like threw like three passes or something. Now we're going to draft him.
Well, I guess he'll probably do as well as Minshew. Oh, no. So we're going to be like Fields frenzy. Ah, everybody get your Fields jersey and come on down to the field, the football field.
Although, kind of by the same thing.
Well,
trying to take Trevor Lawrence, but is Trevor Lawrence really the greatest? I don't know. I don't think so. I mean, he spent a couple weeks out because he got the Rona.
Thanks for tuning in. Tuning in to College Football Talk here. We're going to be telling you everything that we know about the gridiron and all the football things that are happening around. It's great that I'm like trying to fake my way through this bullshit and it sounds like garbage and I have no fucking idea what I'm talking about.
It's been going on around you. You just haven't paid attention.
Yeah, it's in the name. I don't know shit about football. She knows everything about football. It's so funny. My daughter's had to learn that Sunday is about hate. Sunday's about mama yelling at the goddamn TV. No, you did not fuck. No.
Sundays are for hate.
Saturdays are too. I mean, she really hates in college football. Oh my God.
Well, this week.
There we go.
Freaking Alabama. It's supposed to be Alabama at LSU or something. Assuming they don't have much bunch of Rona and are going to cancel it or postpone it.
That's
or something.
This week they're playing that game.
Yeah, today.
Oh my God, was that the Iron Bowl? I always get this wrong. I do it on purpose to ask. So is that the Iron Bowl?
No. And we're not talking about that this.
Oh, that's right. That happened. I'm already scheduled for 5 o'clock whiskey with your dad over football, so that'll be great. I'm looking.
Oh, nice. There you go.
Absolutely. So, over in the world of Disney Collect,
well, you finally got your Tron set.
College Football Talk is we'll catch us next week. But they finally did that Tron set. It's the wrong Tron. It's Tron Legacy, but still, it's fucking Tron. And they didn't do any of the things I wanted with special effects. But still, it's Tron. So
it's Tron. Whatever.
Plus, did you do it? Yeah, I did it. I think I might have done it twice.
I didn't do it. I got mad. I was like, it's not the right Tron.
Yes. I should have gone to the Digicast yesterday and wrote, Tron! Thank you, Tron! But I was literally like, they scheduled up against when I was recording with Previn.
I saw that. That was some bullshit.
When we set the time, I was like, no, watch. They're going to have a Digicast at 2:30 or some shit. And sure enough, at 3 o'clock, there they were. So
man, did you see that in the Discord?
Most of the folks in our Discord are kind of tired of the thing anyways. But
that's great. I love it. Well, they're not wrong, man. All that shit. Like, they were like, this is like 15 seconds of dead air. Like, they're just sitting there and looking at
15 seconds?
Phone.
What are you talking about?
Longer than that? Like
15 minutes.
I know. On. They're just sitting there like, what are they doing? Sending emails? Like, what the fuck?
Yes.
That's what it feels like. It's like watching. I mean, you know, we're guilty of at times of, you know, looking at her phone during the show. It seems like they're doing the whole time. It's really strange. I don't get the entertainment value, but
I don't know. That's like,
The craftable thing. They have a craftable deal for that Tron set. I mean, that's one of those things where I wish I was active in the app to get those little things because you get them in the wheel and claim packs.
Yeah.
And then you have to get 100 of those things for the claim deal.
Yeah. I mean, I probably cycle through Disney. I don't know. 6-8 times a day. So I do open the boxes. So I get a shitload of those. If you need them, just come take them. I don't give a shit.
Like those because I would like to finish. Yeah. I'd like to get the craftables. I think there's two craftables or something like that.
There's only two things. Yeah, come get them. I don't care.
Things, man. And each one's a different, you know, they're not like cross compatible. There's a good guy and a bad guy one.
Right. Yeah.
They're both different melds with different little whatever.
Nah, like I said, just send me a trade every couple of days and just suck them all up. I don't care.
I will.
All right.
Now, Quick Nass will start sending them to me.
There you go.
Quick Nass sends me all kinds of shit on Marvel, too.
Yeah.
All those folks in the Discord are really cool about that. They just did. That's one thing they did in Marvel Collect, moving to that. They have a thing now for those.
To open those.
You do. I want to get. I almost asked for your phone for a few minutes the other day because they have a deal where you can meld common cards for gold base cards.
Yeah, I saw that.
And I think it only goes to the end of the year.
I think so. I only did one, and I got some shitty character.
I meld the shit out of all my fucking commons, except for my man things. So, because they actually opened it up to the 2019 commons as well.
Yeah, I saw that. I have a shitload.
Which I have tons of those. So I'm basically getting to numbers, and then I need to get in there and really get hardcore dupes for needs, dupe for needs, dupe for needs, and get that thing done. Because it's 175 card set.
It's a big set, yeah. It's crazy. Because it's series one and series two.
Right. And it's got the award, of course, is Ghost Spider, which is their Ray.
Yeah.
Is that what goes on in there?
Yeah.
Okay, that makes sense. Okay. Because I was doing that... that one set a couple weeks ago, the heroines or whatever thing.
Yeah.
And I went out and I was like sending some trades, trying to finish some of it. And like the whole, everything in the feed, everything was like, Ghost Spider this, Ghost Spider that, Ghost Spider this. And I'm just like, what the frick is the deal with Ghost Spider?
That's
man?
Their Ray. That's their Ray.
Oh, that explains so much.
Yeah. I mean, you know, she's.
That's
she's...
why you took that Ghost Spider I had yesterday.
Yep.
Okay.
Yes, I did. Yeah, it did. Okay. You don't care about Marvel, but I like wanted to mulch all of your commons into golds because I want to finish that set.
That'll probably come in pretty low. Although when I melded my one, I was surprised at the card count on it already. But you know, whatever.
Yeah, no, they're in the couple 3,000. They'll probably be 5,000 by the end of the month, especially since they added the 2019s, because most people have more of the 2019s, the ones that have been around.
Yeah.
Because you've been doing those claim packs and the wheel and shit like that, and they just come. There's a bunch of packs that you can buy that are really cheap, like the 101, and get, you know, like two packs of that will get you enough to meld a gold. That's just with coins. So that's pretty easy to do. But you need a lot fast while everybody's still trying to work on the damn thing. So I do want to finish that just because I think it'll be a pretty decent award. It was in the sub 500 range when I looked at it the other day.
Oh, wow. Yeah, that's pretty decent. Certainly. I've been trying to finish up the other random base variants, like the green on the wheel, the highlighter. They call it highlighter green and the teal. And I'm just trying to knock out all those base variants to get those done for the year. I'm pretty close on most of them. We'll see.
Yeah, I'm sure I did the other base. I don't really worry too much about, but I'm kind of bummed because I guarantee you, like a million Man-Thing comments just went off into the void. That you know, I've got close to 500, I think, of those. So it wasn't a bad run.
That's nice.
It would be nice to just give me a base card to hoard. You know, kind of like, oh fuck you, Kiefer. We're not going to give you a Man-Thing base card to hoard. You're gonna hoard a common card for 2+ years, and then we're gonna make sure everybody mulches those. So
shit.
Yeah,
it's kind of, that's your penance right there.
They're attacking me personally. I feel
feel attacked.
A little bit targeted. Well, and then they had a set this. I think it was yesterday or Thursday. It was late this week, and it was called Psychedelic.
Yeah, I saw
and
that.
It had two fucking Man-Things in it. Two of them. One of which is art they've just recently used in another set. And they're all art that were in quid sets before. They were all Creature of the Swamp.
Another Doctor Strange award for Aja Marie.
Yes. Yeah, they're targeting her big time.
She just humbled with those awards.
And Ms. Rebecca says she loves the highlighter variant at Marvel.
Yes, it is. Well, she likes green anyway. She collects all the green stuff in Star Wars, so.
Really?
Yeah.
That's odd.
So we should certainly plug Qui-Gon Gin and Tonics podcast too.
Always Scuttlebutt. They're doing it right. They just dropped a big new episode this week. So if you're looking for all the information Marvel collect, please go out, find yourself that Scuttlebutt and check it out because they know what's up.
They know way more than I do. More on Marvel than I do.
Damn sure. Yeah, sir. And they're great guys to listen to. I really enjoy listening to their conversations.
Definitely a good listen.
I put them on when I'm out weeding.
Yep.
Sit out in the when it's nice and cool and sunny and pull weeds and listen to Scuttlebutt. It's great. So with that, I think we're into Star Wars. Oh, shit.
I realized a while back that long-term commitments just aren't my thing, man. 30 weeks, 3 ways to 10. I can't do it. It's too much. I got myself a brand new jam.
I'll be keeping it weekly, baby. I'll be keeping it weekly. I'll be keeping it weekly, baby. I'll be keeping it weekly.
Okay. Marathons in a Minute, Keeping Weekly Edition Series 3, which started back on September 27th. We are in week 10. We're almost done.
All right.
Almost done, and then we'll have a fallow period of nothing.
Oh, it's been so grueling.
It's funny how it goes so fast, isn't it?
The cadence of, you know, just the fabulous cadence they have of content. The
release cadence.
So, yeah.
That's a cavalcade.
Oh, it's a lot.
It's a lot.
Sunday, top choice, editor's choice, whatever you want to call it. They went with my favorite type of thing, and it was somebody doing something.
Okay, good. What were they doing?
It was Ray bypassing the compressor.
Oh, she was so happy. I love that card. She is like, yeah, I did it. That's, and then the Han Solo's kind of like, oh, okay, I don't even know what the fuck that is.
Yeah. Like, all right. But yeah, that, I
love that picture.
I love that. Well, and I like the ones where it's like somebody doing something. You know, not just.
Get you invested.
Yeah.
Yeah, I love that picture though.
Bypasses the compressor.
It just makes you smile. She was so happy.
Yeah. And then.
Oh, Monday. Sorry. Wait, I got to explain something. Ms. Rebecca, on the Twitch version, you don't get the theme song. It's only in the edited version. I'm very sorry.
You have to listen. You have to listen to this twice.
Yes, you have to watch it twice. I apologize.
Just give him a little bit. Give him a little bit.
Gotta tune it in. Let's begin. Marathon's in a minute. Marathon's in a minute. That's
weeping.
The old one.
That's the old one.
I know, I like that one.
But I like that one.
It was a really good. It was a good song.
Well, it goes along with we miss actual real marathons.
Right.
But
yes.
Anyway, we can't have nice things. Monday, back to this, was Heroes, which nobody cares about because Hera was a couple weeks ago.
Right.
This week was Maz.
Maz Kanata.
Yeah.
Which nobody likes. If you ever wanted the easiest horde on earth, horde Maz.
That's just rude.
They'll put her on The Mandalorian and then all of a sudden everybody will fucking love her.
Yeah, right.
She'd be amazing all of a sudden. She could be around.
They could go stop by Tokadana and like.
Let's save that for the end. Even our speculations could be dangerous.
Yes. Okay. Tuesday droids. It was a GA-97, which is the Bongo Crotch droid. It's the droid that looks like it's got
Bongo nuts. Yeah.
Bongo nuts.
I used to call him Bongo Nuts. Once you see it, you can't unsee it. It's like, why do you?
Yeah.
Why? What are you doing?
How is that a functional
thing? You literally have bongo drums at crotch level. And okay, what are you gonna do? You're gonna fucking beat those bongos, baby.
He's got bongo nuts. Yeah,
bongo nuts.
He's got bongo nuts.
Yeah, Wednesday featured creature. It was a reek. Ugh.
Oh boy. Yeah, no, I did get that. Yeah. I hate that there's no bundle for that one. I always have to spend crystals on it.
Yeah.
Then Thursday fan choice tournament because we love the tournament and we love politicians.
Oh man.
So, like we expected, it was Leia versus Bail Organa in the bloodiest conflagration since the Civil War.
That's so unfair.
Right? Yeah, right? And last week was Amidala versus Jar Jar. So, obviously, next week it's going to be Amidala versus Leia.
Princess Leia, could you go ahead and come in here and kill your dad for us? Thanks. He's not my real dad.
I voted for Jar Jar because I thought it would be cool if he won the whole thing.
That's not going to happen.
Never gonna happen.
Nope. And then
yeah, so you're right. It's gonna be Amidala versus Leia, and then
it's gonna be Leia.
Everybody wins.
Yeah, so. Everybody wins.
Right.
But you know, it's gonna be OT for the win. So.
Yep, that is true. I would say that.
And then yesterday, Friday for villains, it was DJ.
DJ, yeah.
Which I saw somebody in the feed for it was like villains, and I was like, oh. Okay.
Then in a need to live.
Yeah. Like totally unnecessary character trait. Yes.
Yeah, from a previous movie.
Yeah.
Because didn't he stutter in The Usual Suspects? I'm pretty sure he did.
Ugh, DJ. I can't. Ugh. Yeah. So yeah, villain. And then we're still a couple minutes away from seeing the concept for this week. Who knows what it will be.
Well, we'll probably judge it harshly.
We'll judge it
We're going
to
judge it harshly.
We will judge it harshly.
Get ready.
Yeah.
We're going to.
Yeah.
It's going to be harsh.
So. And, ooh, yeah, I skipped over, but the award, the Guild of Galaxy this week, which isn't worth crap, is a Chewie and Ray.
Did you get the robot this week? Who was the bot? The droid?
Bongo Nuts.
Oh, Bongo Nuts. Bongo Nuts. Okay. Yeah. Because you try to forget that one a lot.
Yeah, I do. It's super. But,
but you're not gonna forget Bongo Nuts.
You're not gonna forget Bongo Nuts. You're not gonna forget Bongo Nuts.
I envision him on his wedding night. Okay. And his wife's in the bedroom, and then he's in the rest bathroom getting ready, and she hears the sound of drums approaching. Drum roll, please.
No.
Yeah. No.
That was no.
It's like some Donnie Carson level joke, wasn't it?
No.
In terms of age, not in terms of quality. There's like that was. You know, 1970s happening there.
Oh,
that was pretty great. That was pretty great.
Yeah, no.
I thought it was pretty great.
It was not.
Oh. I loved it.
No.
I like whispering.
No.
So is that the whole week? We're just waiting on concept now?
Yeah.
Okay, well, we won't kill time for that.
So. Nope.
Well, we could if we were doing a Digicast. We'd just sit here till
sit there and look at our phones. Just sit there and look at our phones and, you know.
Send some emails.
Yeah.
Not talk to each other.
Oh, let me fuck up our.
Unplug some stuff and replug it in.
I got to fuck up our background. Fuck up our background on Switch a couple of times. Here we go. All right.
Change the background.
They did. You can't see it. No, I did it on Twitch. I changed a bunch of stuff on Twitch.
Yeah.
Twitch only joke. Sorry, guys.
Just sit there in silence.
Yeah, you missed that one. Missed the visual on that one. So, meditation chamber is 18. Wow.
Yeah.
They actually remembered. Yeah. I feel like it may have been 7 days this week that they actually remembered to put the fucking meditation chamber thing in there. I pulled one the other day and got a ray. Yeah, I got a black ray.
Pretty sweet.
Yeah, I put it on eBay and it's not going anywhere. I missed the market on that one. Somebody single-handedly crushed that market. I don't know who it is, but I know that he likes to kill John Wick. So, yeah. So, it's an 18. That's great. Hordes. Hoarding like a bastard on Cheer It.
Let's pull mine up. Yeah.
And I just hit 10,000 yesterday. On that. And all my other numbers too. Crystal and I sat down. We were watching Star Trek, and then after Star Trek, we just did a smash. I sent again. Just as fast as we could. So pumped.
And then
I'd zone out,
like watching the show, and then I'd look, and he'd like had sent me the thing like 10 times or
something.
Yeah,
I was like, see how many you have to hoard. I have to void out now, and there'd be like 20 of them all stacked up because I was literally just going send again.
Nice.
Concept.
It's here.
It is from A New Hope. It is Astromech sketches.
Yeah.
Like little
robots.
Little robots, little things, I guess.
Oh, wow. Those look like is that for New Hope? Wow.
Yeah.
Okay, so that may be actually probably not Macquarie, but based off some of that Macquarie stuff that we saw that earliest bot, because that early R2-D2.
Yeah.
So that may be something cute-ish. That an R2 person may
or a droid person would like it. Yeah,
I have to get it in all colors because I'm a fucking moron. So,
which golds are in legendary?
Yeah.
Why?
No, not those. No,
not the concept.
No, it's those creatures.
Oh, the creatures.
Those feature creature golds.
Stupid.
Yeah, and they suck, man.
That
seriously.
Is stupid.
I have a couple of them that I melded just for shits and giggles, and I get people to throw them at me every once in a while, but they're dead end because nobody fucking wants those.
No.
You know, it's driving me crazy.
Tell me.
Yeah. Okay, I'm gonna tell you.
Tell me.
Because, you know, I'm out there and I'm trying to find some hordes because, you know, Hux is back. So I'm trying to do that. And I'm trying to finish up Trudgeon. And every once in a while, you see people, ooh, trading gilded, you know. And every once in a while, I'm like, yeah, let's see what people got. You go in there and it's freaking gilded galaxy. I'm like.
Yeah. It's amazing that they go. They look at it for the first time in the name. And they go, oh, my God.
I have gildeds.
Trading gildeds for gildeds. Looking for a good one. Like Ray, hint, hint. You know, and they're expecting a gold frame 1, 2, 3 count. No.
Not happening.
That is so annoying.
Yes.
That, and then the ones who are like, trading legendaries.
Yeah.
And it's like it's a bunch always of those fucking creatures.
No, the thing I see, it's always those fucking OB sigs. Always.
All the OB sigs.
I've got rid of every single one of those I've had because I'm always looking for somebody that's going, looking for my first legendary.
I just want to know what it feels like to have
I just want to. Well, it's accompanied by the sound of approaching drums. You're going to find out what it feels like.
You need to write down the approaching drums. That might be the show
the
title.
The sound of approaching drums.
I think that's a good one.
It's unlikely that the best thing that happened this week was Bongo Nuts the Droid. But maybe. I'm ready.
Oh, shit.
Wow. All right. Yeah. So, but no, I saw somebody that was doing that not too long ago. They're like, oh, I'm looking for my first legendary. And so I look at their stack. And they've got one of those white border essential Padmes.
Oh.
Which is, what are those? Like 1400 some count or something like that? I mean, they're
still,
you know.
It's the gorgeous card.
But gorgeous card. Yeah. So I sent one of those OB legendary sigs to them and they accepted and they're like, thank you. And I'm like, no, thank you. You're like, you, because I am definitely going to get more traction off that card than I would ever get off of that shit.
Yes, absolutely.
It was a win. But they got their first legendary and they felt great. So
that's good. See, that's they went to bed happy that night.
And it was offered and accepted. So that's fine.
Can perfect. You background?
Yes. Thank you for reminding me because last week I left it on for ages. So,
that makes it cold because it's like, it's 44 degrees outside. It's cold. God. It's too cold for
there's
water.
This about this.
There we go. Oh man, it makes me think of Galaxy's Edge.
No, I want to go.
Oh my God, I want blue milk. I want blue milk and one of those things from the Ronto Roasters thing.
I know those are so good.
Breakfast wrap things.
They were delicious.
Aren't they open? They're not open again.
They're open.
I thought so.
We could go right now. Let's go. Hey man, I'll tell you what. Let me charge into a fucking wildfire disease.
I have a pass reserved for next week, just in case it would be. You know.
Yeah, not worth it.
No, we'll get there again.
I keep going in and like putting in reservations like in months ahead because like I think I can do like three.
Yeah.
And
they keep coming up in my email and making me sad.
Oh,
like,
right.
Not yet.
So I was like, which I just saw a picture that it was like on Twitter or something from one of the Disney things. And it was like, you know, like the Christmas stuff, which, you know, they get all the Christmas stuff. Which
oh, man, I know.
Crazy. So nice. I went with the Christmas stuff last year when I saw it.
I like the fake snow when it's like,
the
you know.
Fake the snow, but it was like so packed. And then, you know, like zoomed in. Yeah, people were wearing masks and everything, but it was like so many people. I was just like, ooh.
Nope. Not going to be comfortable with that for a while.
And then I also read that the their whatchacallit broke the last week.
The what?
The sky buckets.
Oh no.
Yeah.
Oh really?
The sky buckets for a little bit.
The gondolas or whatever you call them. Yeah.
Yeah, but now instead of giving you like free passes and stuff, they're like you're lucky.
They give you a mask.
You were protected from coronavirus the whole time you were in that thing.
Yeah. Unless you were in the sky bucket with somebody. No, actually, I think they're just doing.
You're stuck in the sky bucket with some guys like, I'm feeling mighty poorly.
No.
My fever is rising.
No, you're only with your party in the sky bucket.
Oh, okay.
So you're not like with randos.
Not some random flushed tourist.
Yeah, some random coughing and sniffling.
Beads wet popping up on his forehead.
Eating a Dole Whip like, I remember these having flavor.
No. Look at my toes, guys. Wow. This must be all this walking. They're really purple.
Yeah. Oh, shit. I remember that.
That was the sky bucket coronavirus joke. Dun, 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 dun. We built it. We did it. We fucking made that one.
Okay.
I think we killed it. So hordes are going great. Hordes are going great. I project I will be complete on Cheer It probably within a week or so. So I'm
pretty awesome
on that one.
Yeah, because
I might still have a bunch. I'm clean mine.
400 Cheer Its I had. So yeah,
I need to get them. I'm going to wait till I get about a couple thousand out before I go to the mattresses, and then I'm just going to turn into the biggest whore on earth and beg all my friends, please send me Cheer Its. I'm so fucking tired of hoarding.
I'm pretty sure that I have a couple.
Two whole weeks I've been hoarding, you guys. You don't know what I've gone through.
And yeah, so two whole weeks.
And mostly my usual lazy ass hoarding. I mean, literally like spam, 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 accept. I did get kind of in the groove in the last week or so of sending hoard trades.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Nope. I did all mine are all done for what 2020. That's seven.
It's definitely okay. Tapered off. Definitely that's not the activity level.
Yeah,
it is
tapered off because there's nothing worse than posting and then you go and you refresh a little bit later and nothing.
Well, I mean, I could stop right now and I would be comfortable because as soon as they announce when the melds are, then a bunch of other people are gonna jump in. And I mean, those wave twos, Jesus Christ, that 5,000 is way too low.
Way too low.
I don't know if there's room enough on the back of those cards. I mean, the font's going to be like 2-point font. Everybody's names on the back.
Yeah.
It's like, you know, it's like when I did Bespin Lay, it was like, ooh, yes, done. And then I'm like, great, everybody in the world is doing Bespin Lay.
As it stands right now, there's one name that's going to be on every fucking wave.
Every card.
Monument. So that's cute.
That's going to be fun.
Yeah.
I wonder if the tops won't care. They won't even notice, probably.
No, they don't give a fuck.
No, but
not expecting to right now. The one thing I do like is when I'm getting kind of low on whites to the part where I'm transferring shit over from my my alt, which I hate that two step. But I love that 2020 pack with the grays, the 2,500 coin pack with the chance of the grays. I'm pulling a bunch of those grays. Every couple of days I get, 100K under my belt.
Yeah.
Go ahead and open some of those packs.
Yep.
Right where my bongos sit.
Right from the bongos.
I get a couple of hundred of them coins, I put them up under my bongos.
Doesn't even make sense.
Whatever. So
why would you want coins under your bongos?
Huh? It adds a resonance.
Wouldn't that be cold?
Huh?
The jingly sound.
Not the way I play them, baby. Warm right up.
Oh wow.
Warm right up. Hot jazz. And I also like the Wizard of Oz was my other comment.
Why?
Just because I like it.
Because.
I was just being dumb. I like the 2020 pack with grays. I like the Wizard of Oz. I was doing the kid.
Oh, you're doing the kid from Christmas Story.
That's
what
I was going for.
The line for
it's my
Santa.
First Christmas reference. Happy holidays, everybody.
Yeah. Wow.
I fucking did it. Merry Christmas. Ho, ho, ho. All right. So.
Okay.
We move into the
sets.
What
sets came out this week? What happened?
All kinds of sets. The Legend Continues, which was that comic book looking set.
Mandalorian, The Legend Continues, thing.
They had shown that on the Digicast. And I liked the
standard card.
The standard card looks amazing. The base variant looks way worse.
Yeah, it's all color. Yeah.
It's got
color.
Motion, but it's monochrome, and it doesn't look as good.
Yep.
Of the two, I prefer the base on those.
The regular one, yeah.
So I'm sure a lot of people are like, oh, I got to get that tougher variant, but I wouldn't call it the better looking one of the two. So
yeah, I wouldn't either.
Energy into that at all.
Yeah, I think I have like three of the five and I'm just like,
I don't care. I got one. It's like all purple. I'm like, oh, okay, cool.
Yeah. What are you cats doing?
You know who'd love that?
The cats Jimi are like Hendrix. Lurking off screen here. Both of them.
They're bad.
So you know something's up.
They're
okay.
Back.
Up on the bellows are they?
Okay.
We're okay now.
And then they dropped the Rise of Skywalker physical port series 2, wave 2, a new beginning. This time it's personal with so many fucking variants and they have those golds and the reds.
Yep.
Where do those fucking purples come from?
Dude, I don't know.
There's
I skipped
too many
all
goddamn
them.
Release structures in this shit. It's fucking, I'm just
there's
doing
there's
nothing.
There's too many different things and too many different workbench melds and all that bull crap. It's like, come on, man.
Yeah. And with no, there's no LE stuff in it either. So it's really kind of like, why bother? Another physical fucking port in multiple waves.
Which, how is there going to be another wave or did they get them all?
That may be another
one. I think that's it. I mean, you could talk about the set that's coming today, but that goes into future sets. So.
That's a subset. Yeah,
we're not there yet. Yeah, we're going chronological. I have to do it chronological on the thing to keep them straight.
Yeah, because my brain don't work
good. That's how I go. Yep. So, all right.
That was the big Sunday thing last week was Rise of Skywalker series 2.
Yeah, that was a pile of poop.
And then with Monday, of course, we have Mando Monday with the 10 base cards and the Kinetic Series 2 in the pack.
Yep.
And later on in the day, we had Chapter 13 scenes.
Yes. And those were with Ahsoka.
Yes.
Some really great looking cards.
Nice looking shots.
I pull a couple of golds and I have to get the fucking magistrate every time.
Which,
you know?
Did you realize that she is Bruce Lee's goddaughter?
Okay.
Didn't know that.
So she probably knows, she knew Kung Fu when she was born.
Yes.
They slapped her on the ass and she turned around and fucking kicked the doctor right in the bongos.
Right in the bongos. Yeah.
That's how she cried, like Bruce Lee. Ah! Then she'd go like this. Bruce Lee's
goddaughter and the governor or whatever of that place. You know, the guy who, like, Mando ran into and then later on got restored back to his role. He apparently is a Disney legend, like, Imagineer guy.
Oh, cool.
Like, you know, designed a bunch of Disney ships and things and is actually one of the Disney legends.
Hmm.
And they put him in there.
He's Bruce Lee's uncle.
No way. That was just some trivia for the people.
Okay, well,
that's pretty cool though. And I do all those. I've been doing those sets through gold.
I like that.
They, you know, just filling it in.
Mm-hmm. Golds are a bitch on those. They're not terrible, but they kind of.
So, do you do those 13 scenes? Are you doing? I mean, those.
Yeah, I've been doing
those. Gold.
You go through the gold and everything. Yeah.
Yeah.
He's bonkers.
Yeah. I'm doing bronze, and then sometimes I'll do silver. I'm usually doing silver on them as well, because a lot of times people will pull a silver and they're not trying to do them, and they'll trade them for bronzes.
Oh yeah, real quick, man. People that are pulling golds that won't do them, dude. I'll load them up with silvers and bronzes real quick and take a gold. Yeah,
I'll pull like one or two, and it's usually some dog. I didn't get, you know, one of the cool Ahsoka ones,
sabers. Yeah,
I have to get the magistrate who's. Now cooler to me.
See?
She's better. So there that's great. And
you're
then we had the...
wow, yes. Then, because Monday was the 30th, Tuesday at midnight, it was December.
Yes.
So the holiday countdown begun.
Happy holiday. It's a new event for you.
It's an event. Something else to put in the events because those rust things are ridiculous. So let's put more stuff in the events. So
well, they should call those rust. They shouldn't call it the Rainbow Chase. It should be like, go to eBay Chase. Who the fuck is going to go through that every goddamn, you know, fuck that
shit.
It's going to piss me off when it's time for Hucks. And it's like the chore hoard. People are using up Hux's for that crap. That's just obnoxious.
They'll have so much fucking base by
then. It just shows you that they do not understand people and hoarding because fucks with people's hoards.
Yes.
It's not nice.
Well, it's like the chore hoard when they did that.
Exactly. It's not nice. Yeah.
Which was, that was what, S6?
Oh, the chore hoard. Oh, the weekly thing. Oh, yes. They don't get it. They have not, and I know people have tried to explain it to Mark and them, but they do not understand hoarding.
No. No, they don't. In fact,
I mean, it's pretty easy to be flippant about it, and really, it's a matter of understanding how deep the disease goes. Yeah. They never seem to really understand how, you know, fucked up it is what we're doing. They don't really get that, you know, and how personal we take it as well.
Yeah.
I mean, that's what really plays into it, is this stupid thing. It's got to piss them off that this stupid thing that gets them almost no money, there's really very difficult for them to monetize. It's easy to resist monetization on these things that does nothing for them that we take so personally. That's the thing that they just got to drive them crazy. It's like this third rail that they didn't create. They never wanted this for themselves. You know what I mean?
Right. And it does nothing for them. It does nothing for their bottom
line. This nonsense they try and do with it.
If they were able to understand and actually key off of the mind of a hoarder, they would probably be better at making money off of
the chore hoard. They probably, you know, because they called it, you know, like the weekly hoarding thing. No, it's not.
Right.
No, it was not. It was fake based, number one. They made it. bullshit extra cards.
Obnoxious.
It was. It was completely obnoxious. And the fact that they have an event now that encourages cycling, something that exactly
specifically tells you. You have to cycle between people to do that stuff. It's so appealing.
Well, that's probably why they had to let Lost Sailor back in, because cycling is a way of life. He got banned for cycling, and now it's like, fuck, man, our whole fucking app is built around cycling.
Yeah, it's all it is. Galaxy. Cycling.
It's unbelievable.
They don't get it. The dartboard are bad ideas. You know, they're going to have to replace the stuff underneath
with
it.
With bongos.
It's full of holes. They just got to replace
it. It's gone. It's just
the bongo's a bad idea.
The bongo.
It doesn't generate any ideas. They just like it.
Just all day long.
God. That was completely no.
So.
Wow, but you're right. No. But yeah, so back to the holiday countdown nonsense. Yeah.
Oh, wow, what a mess. So they really fucked it up.
Because there's a little, you know, free thing. You have to go in there and you're supposed to get like a little card that's got like a one on it. And then you can get some snow variants because, you know, you got to have more variants.
Yeah, those are nice looking variants.
But they're nice. They're nice. The snow is nice on the sides, even though initially they really look a lot like the white base. But
they fixed the thumbnail a little better.
The thumbnail's a little bit better, but you still have to be careful.
Yes, I always am now. Even though I have like 15 of every one, so why bother being stingy about it? Go ahead. Give me 9 fucking white
but
shirts.
But it's like,
and we're
I'm
good.
Wondering, like, what was their original intent with those snow base?
That well,
it was going to be
not
like
that.
a hard variant to do. But pretty much everybody just was able to open packs and complete it. Well, no, actually, there's only 89 of them, which is like, where are the rest of them going to go? What kind of horrible mechanic are they going to put out there that's going to involve
maybe they're in the
rest?
Christmas presents.
Ooh.
They might be in the Christmas presents.
Ooh, okay.
I think somebody mentioned that it's the Mandalorian ones that are not in the set.
Yes, yes. It's all the Mandalorians that are not there. The ones from the Mandalorian. And, you know, the thing was broke. So people were railing that
it
thing.
Was the first frenzy of 2020, really.
For probably, what, 8-9 hours?
Yeah, we didn't catch on to it. I woke up at 7.
I caught on to it in the morning when I woke up. So I got, you know, about an hour before I had to work.
Right.
Yep.
But it only ran till about 8:45. And then they obviously, when they came into the office and said, hey, how's things going with our little automated event that we sent a timer for with fucking Alexa last night to set off at midnight?
Don't say her name.
Alexa.
Don't say her name.
Alexa, drop the holiday countdown sets at midnight.
Why don't you do that when nobody's at the office?
It's probably going to fucking play a song in a minute. So that'll
probably. Well, one of these
Get
days.
Up, Alexa.
It's in the other room. God, so.
One of these days.
I don't understand this automated system of everything's going to be fine. Shut it off.
Well,
walk
it's
away.
Like what they did with Black Friday.
Right.
Exactly.
Ooh, I automated it, and ooh, now I'm going to go.
It's all
and
good.
Watch football.
Drink up, boys.
It went badly.
Well, this wasn't bad.
This wasn't bad because people got a lot of base and everybody got a lot of those snow variants, and, you know, so it's pretty easy to see who got in on that because they've got tons of those snow variants.
Yeah. I mean, I've got, like I said, about 15 of each. I just blasted it as long as it lasted.
And then they also have a ton of the number one cards.
And then the super rares when they got 100 super rare cards.
Yeah, well, yeah. Then the red one that's a super rare, I ended up with 2 of those.
Yeah.
Yeah. We were doing our part to blast because I don't remember what the odds were on that red one in that pack. Those 1 in 25.
I don't know. I haven't managed to get one out of the regular.
No, gosh, you're not going
one,
to.
No.
Well, you can buy. No.
Yeah.
So you got 25 of these things to collect for the month, and then there'll be something that happens at Christmas where they'll show all the presents. What cards did we get? And then they've got a base version which you get free every day. Plus, does it give you coins as well?
I think 5,000 coins. Yeah.
Yeah, I think it gives you coins every day as well. So that's kind of nice. And then at the end of the month, we'll sit there. And then they have a red one that's like the super rare that you can just buy for diamonds. You can pull for coins, or you can just buy a bundle and get it.
Yeah.
But pulling it for coins is very hard.
Yes.
Yeah, it's one in 500 coins.
Chance. Yeah, but you can buy coin packs. There's no 500 coin pack for those? There's not? There's no coin pack.
It's a crystal pack.
Oh, it's only crystals. Okay.
No.
That's why they fixed it.
Yeah.
That's why they
fixed
it.
They weren't
going
to get those sweet
crystals.
Yeah, exactly.
Crystals. Yeah. Ooh, yeah.
Sweet crystals. They love them.
Yeah. So That was quite something. It's been, and it was funny because everybody was like, they really gave us something nice for Christmas. Yeah.
Oops.
It's a frenzy.
Yeah.
Oops.
Yeah. I thought it was
like, oh no, they wouldn't do something nice like that. No, it was a mistake. So then it was like probably about like 8:30, about 9 o'clock, we hit maintenance mode on Monday.
Yes.
When they realized they had somebody who came into the office and was like, oh no, guys, the automation, we have a problem. Yeah.
I never believe it. Something went wrong.
We had to have, you know, start off Monday with some maintenance mode.
Yeah,
so
that was fun.
Maintenance mode. It's always good.
Yeah. Really good job, guys.
It's really good.
But, you know, it's been working right ever since. Now you just get the one pack. And even though it's annoying because the pack stays there, but then it tells you, oh, no, you don't get any more of those.
Yeah.
It looks like you
can get it. It should, like, go away.
It should go away.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's probably a simple thing to code, which they're just, like, too lazy to do it.
Well, you know.
Well, it doesn't fit in with the
Mrs. Johnson's middle school coding for kids class is only able to do so much. You know,
yeah,
you're gonna earn those fucking baseball team jerseys or whatever.
Yeah.
So,
yeah. So moving on from the holiday countdown, which continues but not as fun because there's not free cards. We had more Parallax this week. We had Kessel.
But it was a solo set.
It was a solo Kessel, but it has that nice Kira in it. So it's got like one card people want in it.
Right.
And the rest is like garbage.
Is that the young Kira?
Yeah.
The red dress Kira, whatever.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's got the Slurpee guy I don't like in it.
Yeah, the Slurpee guy. So he was like one of the
Tulsa. Yeah, I hate that guy.
The header character there.
Yeah, he's got that slurp thing where
it's
like
slurping.
He's walking around with like some little slurp thing. He just slurped. Oh,
yeah.
I hate that guy. Well, it's gross.
He's got to stay hydrated. That's important.
Is that what it is? I think it's beer. I don't know. I think he's like got one of those beer packs. There were those like those beer hat things where people drink out of. And they have a little thing and drink from their. I think that's what it is.
Okay.
Cool. In my mind, that's
he's ready to go to a football game.
That's my headcanon.
Right, he's got the foam dome.
Drinking beer.
Party! Well, that's a terrible thing.
Yeah.
And then,
speaking of terrible things.
No, wonderful things. Wonderful things. We have a different opinion on this one because I love to scrap and scrounge and scrap and be a scavenger. And you'll hear the sound of approaching drums if you've got any of those components in your stack, baby, because I'm coming after them, man. So they did an update on the scavenger, scrapper, schematic, scumbag.
Yes.
Extravaganza. And so they had a thing where you could meld those ones that everybody has like 18 of.
Yeah.
You could meld those for a pack and it would give you a chance at one of the other components. So you would never get those two super common ones, but there are a lot of other really common ones that you.
Yeah, like the hyperdrive is what I got.
Yeah. So some people were.
I made a TIE fighter.
Yeah. Crystal made a TIE fighter. I did the very first Y wing. And then when I went to do another one, it was already at 3. No, it was at 2. And so I did the third. So I had 2 of 3 for a while, but now it's like up to 9. So I hate it.
Yeah.
I have enough to meld one right now, but that pack meld only lasted till like yesterday about 4 or something like that.
Yeah. I saw that. Yeah. Cause it's gone now.
Well, they did give some more information at least. There's a transmission that actually gives you odds on the individual, the groups. There's tiers of these components. And there's some that are, there's one that's like 1 in 25,000 or some shit.
Something like that. It's like
a seismic charge.
Oh, that's right. Nobody has that one yet.
No, there's one out there and it's locked.
I think that's for the TIE bomber, I believe. I think you need that for the TIE bomber.
No, I think those are proton bombs.
Maybe that's right. That's true.
Yeah, I don't even know that there's a meld that uses that component yet.
I don't know. I haven't melded any of them because I don't have enough fucking things to do.
I'm really close to one of the, there's a shuttle that takes like, goddamn, it's like 14 or 15 components.
Yeah.
I think it needs like 4 of the solar collectors, which is pretty.
Sentinel class shuttle. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah, you're right. Look at that.
So those are fun. All the ship guys are having a big old time with that. And I got, you know, a bunch of the guys in our group were melding. I was thinking of doing a B-wing too. I like that B-wing and it's pretty, it was one of the lower count melds thus far, but they've shown that they're going to put these components in like random packs from time to time. They'll just be like, oh, this pack also has components.
which would be cool. I mean, if it's a long-term thing or an ongoing thing, that'll be fine. I'd like to meld them as I get the pack through. So we'll see.
Well, when I realized they had that meld for the pack thing for the other components in it, it was clear that I was finally going to be able to meld the Y-Wing. I started getting out there and going after those ones for the meld packs.
Yeah.
And I was easily trading Women of Star Wars orange and purples for those.
Nice. Then people were picking those up quick, huh?
Uncommons and rares with nice. Boobs and sigs, which I had tons of because of that fuck up.
Yeah.
So I was able to trade into a lot of those that way. And then there was a few that are really tough, like the proton bombs are tough, and there's a turbo laser thing that goes on this that's like a side of a Y-Wing or something that's tough. And then there's the Rebel pilots are in demand for all the Rebel things.
Yeah, because they're widely used, right? Yeah.
Right. So because they go into all of those. So those are pretty, you know, it's kind of fun to get out there. And really, I was literally scrapping and scrounging and scavenging and you know, really kind of doing what they wanted us to do with that. And then I had guys that were like, come on, man, what the fuck are you doing? Seriously, you send like for 9 of these things that they have 20 of that are in the 30,000-40,000 range, those ones that were just dirt fucking common, and they're not doing anything with them, and you're sending them, you know, nice rares and uncommons, female characters, good stuff that they can use for trade bait, and or even better, I was actually going in looking what they liked and offering things like that, and they would come back with just absolutely ridiculous shit. I'm just like, no, you're not going to get your first essentials for 9 of those things. What the fuck are you doing? Happened.
No, that's
seriously, I had a guy that fucking tried to do that.
Fuck that.
Gotta be kidding me.
Yeah, there's no chance I'd know. Silliness.
After trying to turn the green skin green into Thunderdome back here.
Oh, God. Oh.
That's what I'm watching.
They're having big fun over there. They're already pushing it. Get away from there.
He just stares.
They're having so much fun.
I'll come stand on you.
Come on your
That's
back.
A good, yes.
There you go.
Seismic charge component. That's the one that's only one, and it's for Slave One. Which, do they have a Slave One meld?
I don't. There is a meld for it. Let me see. I don't know if
then, that must be the one. You're gonna get this. You gotta have to have that seismic charge.
No.
See, I would like that, but unfortunately, it's like some cartoon Slave One or something. I think
Slave One is kind of badass now.
Yeah. Well, we'll talk.
Yeah. I know.
Yeah. So then,
I swear I saw it on here. Now I can't. Yeah, maybe not.
What are you doing, Cat?
Sitting right
he's
on
like
the green
sitting
screen.
On the green sitting screen, right and on he's the crazed. Green.
Yeah, he's got crazy eyes.
Is he?
Anyway, so yeah, melding Y-Wings is fun. I like to scrap and scrounge, and it'll be interesting to see if they do more of that. I see guys that are clearly like hoarding shitloads of components. So I was kind of getting and burning. And these guys are just like sitting on stacks of them. So somebody's having fun with that. So that's cool.
Well, that is cool. That's pretty neat.
And then we had more guards. Why more guards? What's left to guard in this world?
I did them.
I did not. Not doing them. Although the award is cool. The award's a real deal Royal Guard, not the Red Guard.
Yeah.
So
I did them just because the credit packs was
I prefer the
stock up on some more base. So I was just like, yeah, okay.
I prefer the Red Guard. Because he's so red.
He's so red.
Oh, he's so red.
He is red. Is the Phantom? The Phantom must be either easy to meld or very popular because there are 763 of these things made already.
Yeah, I kind of wanted to meld the Outrider too, that YT-1000. That's the Outrider, I'm pretty sure. So
I think so. That's the Dash Rendar's ship.
Yep. Exactly, Dash Rendar. So I'm be interested to see somebody say it online. I'm dying for him to bring back Dash Rendar on the Mandalorian.
Ooh.
That'd be fun. Huge shoulder pads.
It could happen.
It could.
Huge shoulder pads. So yeah, Guards Way 5, boo. Crystal did them. Who cares? Yeah. And then they did a redux on the Black Friday melds that they fucked up last Friday. They had a second go at all of those for 1 hour. I had melded a bunch of those. I had a couple where I told you the melds didn't go through. It feels like they just said, just give them all the melds again. Cause I had three on all of them again.
I did.
Hmm.
Which I didn't even do. I did meld on wave 5, which apparently they'd fucked up the support pack on that. the 500 coin support pack for the fifth drop was giving out like 15 cards.
Oh yeah, yeah, that's the one that had gin in it. So
yeah,
it
was... everybody was blasting the living shit out of it. I missed that. I didn't catch on until too late because I would have ripped the shit out of those packs just for the base. You know.
Yep, that's what I did.
So I missed that, so I'm mad. Ah, angry. So hopefully everyone's happy and they were able to get their gins. I didn't look to see where the numbers came in for the finals on that. Watch the ones that were the shortest will probably end up being the highest now.
Probably.
Yeah.
Because Jin was short. She was like at 1,000.
Yeah, she was roughly half of the drop before and I had, third of the first drop.
Yeah, I had two of her from the first time around. Now I have three. But you're right. So I didn't get an Ahsoka, so I'm pissed about that. Bummer. Nobody, and I keep trying to trade for one, but nobody wants to trade me for one.
I was lucky I was able to trade like in the last 15 minutes of the fifth drop on the day of, I had pulled a dupe Jin and I traded it for the Ahsoka.
Yeah, nice.
At the time, because everyone was realizing, oh shit, they're not going to fix this. The counts on these are going to be fucked. Yeah. And then later on, of course, they did fix it, but it all worked out. But I mean, is there going to be an award for all these things, you think?
I don't know. If we send up, you want a lightning snap Wexley at the end of this thing? Or
yes. Yes.
No falling on snap Wexley, lightning snap. Mando Monday snap Wexley.
Sounds like a movie. Snow falling on snap Wexley.
And his bongo drums.
And his bongos.
With his friend. Nuts. Don't look up at that like it'd be fun to climb, dumbass. You don't even have any fucking claws.
Stop, bro. Moron.
They used to be there.
Now he's looking down at the ground like, I was bad.
Okay. So anything? Did we miss anything? Is there anything in the world of Star Wars did we miss before we go to coming soon?
I'm looking. I don't see anything. I think that covers it.
All right. And so we kind of hit on, we're going to get a ROS weapons set, which is a subset of the ROS 2.
Yep.
If you want to see those, there's a Ray. I don't think they'll be... It may be small enough to guild, but I don't know. Probably not.
Our buddy Leamy Mercer's excited, man. There's a pretty No, there is though.
No, not you. Not you, man. No. Don't tell about Leamy Mercer.
He'll be excited.
Why is he excited?
Well, because there's a pretty
story.
Ah, damn it. Damn it.
The cat just lunged at the green screen.
Yeah, runs away. No, I'm kidding. Cat. So why is Leamy Mercer?
I don't know.
You're not gonna kick that football, Charlie. No. Come on, man. I wasn't gonna do it again.
But we will see if they're limited counts. So
yeah, it'd be nice if they would do that. They've had some some recent success with things with the 15, the 50, the 100. That's a little spice.
Yeah, it's getting there if they're doing it like that. That's decent. They don't have to guild everything, but, 15 is cool.
Well, it's been a while since we had a gilded drop.
It's like Asia Marie just sent you that Ahsoka mat.
Oh, what a sweetheart. Really? She's the best. Yep. That's so nice.
There you go.
I was trying to get rid of my bib. I had an extra bib for it yesterday, and nobody wanted it.
Thank you, Asia Marie.
I think I know somebody who probably wants that bib.
Yeah.
Midichlorian
back. I gotta repost his midichlorian tales videos. I had taken him down I had taken him down a while ago and I'm gonna put him back up again.
Do it. That's good. Cool.
When he did the little stories
and
stuff.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure I still have them somewhere.
Those were
I got him.
He would write some crazy good.
Dig those. Yeah. Those are fun.
Very fun.
All right, so that's what we have to look forward to for today. I don't know. And they said that there's gonna be a motion Mando set. Remember how spicy you were about motion Mando? And then they're going to have a watch party for Return of the Jedi. So get ready for some biker scouts, Matt.
And maintenance mode.
And biker scouts that are, 50,000 card count, I'm sure.
Collect them all.
That's right.
Got to be the first guy in your block to collect them all.
I'm sure somebody will trade some to you for maybe, an essential or something.
Maybe. Yeah,
or
maybe.
I can't believe that you're leaving that platinum Fett unlocked.
Yeah, it's unlocked.
Shits
and giggles.
Dude, you show me the offers that come in on that. I just like choke. I'm so fucking scared of an accidental accept on something like that. It terrifies me.
I know. On one hand, I want to lock it so I never have to worry about it. And on the other hand, it's like, if I lock it, I'll never see these crazy offers, so they'll never come in. So
plus, you just kind of want to walk it around, right?
Yeah. Yeah. Well, I mean, like, I don't know. That's a big part of the sickness, as we say, right? Like, it's, I mean, there's plenty of stuff I lock because I don't want to accidentally trade it away or whatever. But I think part of our sickness is that, you know, you want people to see it and appreciate what you have. I don't, you know, I'm not buying all the gilded of certain types of things and stashing them, hiding them in an alt and locking them away. Why would you do that?
Why would somebody do that?
Right.
So
it's fun to have a baller stack.
There's something about like people being able to come and see what you have and appreciate your collection. And it's really cool. And I get a lot of, I'm sure you guys do too, but people are like, holy shit, like this is a crazy awesome collection. You've done, you know, a really good job putting it together or whatever. And people say nice things. And if people can't find those cards or come see them, then I don't know. It probably comes from some of the multi, you know, the MMO games that I used to play too, which is, you know, you deck yourself out in some badass gear and like people can see it and check it out. And you had to do crazy quests to get stuff and whatnot. And people can see that and they can appreciate that. So I think locking stuff away, well, on one hand, it protects it. On the other hand, it hides it from everybody and nobody can come and see it and appreciate it. So anyway, that's a soapbox for another day.
I was curious about that.
Yeah. So a lot of my stuff is unlocked. So some stuff I have locked
a ton recently. It's like when they gave us like 700 locks, I started feeling like I didn't need to lock as much stuff for some reason. Like, we need more locks. We need more locks. Here's 700 locks. Unlocks everything.
Here's a time when I do use my locks is when I get like a dupe in a really popular set and I'm still trying to finish the set.
Yeah.
And let's say like I got in the last, I don't know, the Mando, the gold ones. And I got two of that badass Ahsoka. Well, I locked it. I locked the dupe because I knew the ones that I needed to finish the set. That's the first thing somebody's going to come and try. And
right. Yeah. And a lot of times I see people that aren't even trying to do the set. Exactly. They just want to upgrade their dud. Mm-hmm. From somebody that's trying to finish the set. And so it's like, oh yeah, give me that Ahsoka and I'll give you this turd magistrate. And it's right. Working for me. Matt, accept my trade. I got the magistrate I'm trying to get rid of. God damn it.
Exactly. Or another example is the Mando Monday stuff, right? Like I have a couple of Padmes. I lock them bitches because I always post that I will trade my dupe Mando Mondays for the Biker Scout Mando Monday. But if I unlock those Padmes, they'll be gone tomorrow. They'll be gone instantaneously.
Instantly.
Yeah. So I lock shit just because I don't feel like trading it for stuff that it's not worth quite that much. So
I mean, you don't run an alt either. So, you know, it's really tough for you. You know, I mean,
you know what I got. Come look at my stack.
Right. Yeah. It's what you see is what you get. It's all here. I mean, I don't keep much on my alt. And it's nothing. Anybody that looks at my alt's gonna be like, "Oh, okay. Well, that guy doesn't know what the fuck he's doing," because everything there is pretty much junk. Just to swap back and forth to keep it fair and stay off the algorithm radar, hopefully.
Exactly. So.
So
yeah, we'll see.
Have you got any shout outs this week? Anybody been really nice to you this week, Matt?
I thought about it, so I do. Let's see. Of course, in our Discord, in the Horde Illuminati Discord. We did a Secret Santa. And
yes.
Shout out to Hopkin for volunteering to do
it. Sure, yeah, and he ran it really clean too, man. I mean, it's like it was up. Everybody got in. Boom, there he is. Done. Already sent mine. Already got mine.
And if the people that are in there, man, if you guys go in, people have posted what they've traded for and what they've gotten. Jesus, people got really, really good stuff. Nobody's getting the shaft because everybody respects everybody in there and treats each other right. So I think that was really cool. So I want to thank Hopkin for, number one, putting it together. And number two, our buddy John, OB to OG, who was my Secret Santa.
Oh, yes. Oh. I saw he took very nice care of you, sir. My goodness. He did. That was a really nice card.
A 10 count. A 10 count white comic card art.
Yeah, classic art.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, white saw classic that. Arts. Wow.
Scout. Those are nice looking cards, too. It was really clean for a character collector, too.
And yes. And tangentially, I guess, another shout out might go to Jermaine for doing what he's doing.
Yes. Well, he took it out to the he took it out to the Facebook group yesterday. So he's going to be a busy boy.
Yeah. So I feel like I can say it now.
Yeah.
Because word is pretty much out there in every place. But he's doing God's work and getting a lot of that stuff that we may have probably never been able to see get it back into the community.
Right. Yeah. I mean, it's really interesting to see a collection that big. We're speaking, of course, of Mac 13.
Yeah.
His stack. Who he had basically walked away from the app a while back and just kind of disappeared. He's always been a very enigmatic fellow.
Yeah.
To say really the least.
No sense of anything about him in the app, but Jermaine should write a fucking article just about this.
Yeah.
Seriously, because anybody that knows Mac 13's collection, it was fucking ridiculous.
It's legendary. He was the biggest baller there ever was. I mean, when you talk about ballers like that, you're talking
right. I mean, it's fair to think of somebody having more or in their stack than, like, say, Parm the Palm.
Yeah.
But that one's ridiculously orders of magnitude beyond.
Yes.
It's insane.
And so Jermaine was able to talk to the guy personally.
Right. And I mean, the story behind getting into how he was able to get in touch with him, what he's basically doing is brokering all these sales for the guy. So basically, you know, set up a trade, you get in touch with him, you work out a price, you send the money, he says, go ahead and accept this, and boom. So it's a lot of work going on. He's basically the intermediary on this. And every so often Matt goes in and just accepts trades. Able to get that they thought they'd never have.
Yeah, stuff you'll never see, you would never have seen, stuff that should have, that would never be available in the community, is not going to die in that account, because it was going to die in that account.
Right. Yeah, and I mean, especially like those blueprints. I mean, he literally dominated that blueprint drop when it came out, and just absolutely, he must have had like at least all the silver, you know, a complete set of silver, guaranteed full set of bronze, and possibly a full set of the golds. I mean, he was stacked.
I'm trying to think if there was a gold that he didn't have, and I don't think there was. He had just everything. And if anybody, before this whole thing happened, if anybody came across a gilded blueprint, it was super, super fucking rare, because he had them all. He had almost all of them. I mean, I know there was an X-Wing, a bronze X-Wing floating around. I had a silver Falcon. I still have it. But if you ever came across one of the gilded blueprints, it was a miracle, because...
Well, there were so many of them where he had all of them. He'd have the gold. He'd have both the silvers, all three of the bronze.
All the bronze, yep.
Yeah, just completely buttoned up. So, you know, like, and that's... I think that's where the Y-Wing was for me. And I had tried on a number of occasions to get the gold Y-Wing blueprint from him, and just nothing was going to move those. Nothing, never coming out of that stat. A lot of other little things. The other thing that I picked up out of there was that lime green loot board. He had the other one.
The other half of that.
The other one.
You did get that?
Yeah, I did.
Oh, yeah. Nice.
That's awesome.
And you're not taking it. So, like in one of those little, cufflink situations that I nailed down. So I have both of those lime greens. That's the one that caused me such misery, because it looked white for a long time.
Yep. And it changed six ways
to Sunday before they finally got it right, but it's correct. And then they fucked all the other ones up.
Yeah.
A lot of those S5 borders are still all over the place.
He had he had half of the 1cc from S5. He has so many S5 1cc from the 5-4-3-2-1 of that, and a ton of the lightning, the 2cc, that ton of those lightnings he had.
Yeah, I got other hucks off of him.
Right.
Yeah, a beauty.
Yeah, because I got a bunch of low count hucks so I could 1-2-3 both S5s and S4, I think it was.
Yep. Nice. Very cool.
Yeah.
Yeah. He had it all. You know, a lot of people getting in there and getting a lot of stuff out. I mean, I can't even calculate. Got to be hundreds of thousands of dollars by now that have gone through.
I know what I've spent.
we've heard of people buying packages in the thousands of dollars. So
shout out to Jermaine for getting that done and then doing something really cool with it and getting it out there into the hands of the collectors. Because anybody could have used that for their own personal gain and then just been done with it.
Right. Yeah, exactly. Go ahead, shut it down. I got what I want out of it.
That one card I was still considering ended up where I thought it was going to.
Oh, no.
Well, no, it's okay. It went to Thomas.
And Thomas has it.
Yeah, it's the Job Well Done Award. In silver.
Oh, that's got Phasma on it.
Yeah, it's got Phasma and Hux on it.
Yeah. You know.
You have one of those already or no?
Yeah, I did. I earned it. She didn't just buy it
from Mac Tommy.
Which actually, ironically, I had to trade Mac a gilded to get the last card I needed to actually earn it.
Nice.
Interesting.
When those were dropping.
Wow. What gilded was it?
It was a nice silver Luke or something.
Mm.
Yeah. Sweet. But it was like, I had to do it.
Yeah, you got to do what you got to do.
I got to do it.
But
I have the gold of that now.
What a man.
I have the two gold Last Jedi awards now that I never thought I would have.
Right. Those are two counts.
One
counts. One counts. Holy shit.
Gold, one counts.
Yeah. So I probably used up all my shout outs there for the month. That's three of them.
Sure. Well, I mean, great shout out to Hopkin. I wanted to shout out to Call Me Nemo. He was my Secret Santa and sent me a very, very lovely gift. And it was really, I felt bad accepting it because he does so many nice things for the Discord.
He's
a nice, informative guy. Really like our town crier. He's always finding things and posting things that are just incredibly helpful. Really great member of the community. Really, really enjoy having him over there. Such a super bunch.
Yep, fully agree. He's always, a lot of times, the first to tell us something's happening or something.
Yeah, and Dark Paper was sending me tons of trades, Horde trades this week. A lot of the Discord folks have been sending Horde trades and stuff like that. So it's wonderful. Just love having that group all together and being nice to each other. You know who we haven't seen a lot of lately? They must be very, very busy. Sasha's dad.
Yeah, he must be a busy man right now. Yeah. Poor guy. I miss the guy.
Yeah, I do too. Hopefully he'll come back around. I haven't seen him in a while.
He's great.
But we'll see him again soon. So I guess with that, we could probably go to, unless you got any shout outs.
I can't.
Shout out to me. Cool. Thanks. I am great.
I don't know. I did a bunch of trades this week, so it's all blending together.
Yeah.
Shout out to everybody out there sending more trades.
Taking the trades.
Yeah. I'll just blanket shout out.
Yeah.
Just covering the shout outs, everybody. Little sprinkling shout outs.
You get a t-shirt cannon with shout outs.
Exactly.
Foop.
There you go.
Foop. Get one in the back row. Yeah. Shoot a protester from 5 feet away in the chest. Poop.
Oh, jeez. Not cool, bro.
Too soon.
I guess with that
we'll run like hell to what you're watching. Okay, so you gotta
tell me what you're watching on your TV tonight. Tell me what you're streaming on your iPad. Tell me what you're watching every day and at night. I'll be outside watching from the bushes.
What are you watching? Matt, please.
For the love
of God.
Did you watch?
Son of a bitch. Get him out the fucking hell.
Come on.
Seriously.
Come on. My kid even watched it in civics class already. Come on, man. Hamilton, why do you?
But I am watching stuff. I am actually watching stuff, but I haven't watched Hamilton.
Well, we can't talk about Mando until after what you're watching. So
we can say, you know.
We're not in spoiler warning yet. So what else have you been watching?
Let's see. Mando. And other than that,
not Hamilton.
We've been watching a little bit of Star Trek TNG lately. I don't know why.
Next gen.
Classic. Yeah.
Nice.
That's kind of good. It's all right. So,
have you ever watched Picard?
No. No, I've never.
Either. I didn't get into it. I didn't care for it.
But we've been watching TNG, and that's kind of fun. Just for
something to put on in the background.
Hmm?
Have you watched it before?
No, never did.
Oh, really? Oh,
yeah. Wow. So it's good. So like,
man, some fucking epic shit, some cliffhangers. Wow. I mean, they like invented.
They
some cliffhanger
they did
shit.
Like, how far are you in Next Gen?
I don't know. I don't know. I mean, I could tell you the last one we watched or whatever, but I don't know.
Did you get
like,
to the Borgs yet?
Nope.
Wow, that's when shit gets real.
Oh man,
shit gets real when you see some Borgs. You'd be like, oh, buckle up.
I remember when those like were airing the original
Yes,
me and my brother were always watching those, and when that stuff happened, we just lost our dang minds.
I had a friend that I used to call about it, and literally like a second it ended, my phone's ringing. Yeah, he's like, you fucking believe this shit? Oh my god!
No, I don't know. We went.
It's big, big, major big, shit.
Major.
Yeah. So
I don't know. We saw the one where the holodeck was fucking up, and then they had the binary people, and then after that, the binary people stole the Enterprise, right? And they did that, and then there was another one on. After that, the one where the people wanted to take the children, they kidnapped the children because they couldn't have kids on their planet or whatever because of the ozone layer or whatever.
The first couple of seasons they kind of got it was kind of like Freak of the Week a little bit, get used to the new universe, and then in the second and third season that's where they started getting into some pretty cool long form type.
Because every episode's pretty self contained, right? So
That's how it had always been up to that point, and it really wasn't a thing for things to run in a kind of a serial way. You wanted the short attention span of people to pop in 1 hour and. Sure. Like it or don't. If you didn't like that one, next week is a different freak.
Yeah, so that's it. That's kind of pretty much what we've been doing.
Well, we think. Approved that.
Yeah.
Oh, good. Yes, all right. Good stuff there.
Still watch Hamilton. You should. But
yes, you should.
I will. We will get there.
That's good. Well, what did I watch? I'd forgotten to mention last week. I didn't watch that this week. But have you ever seen a movie called Bad Boys with Sean Penn?
No, I'm thinking of the one that's got like Will Smith or something, wasn't it?
Everyone remembers that one. Nobody remembers the one from 1980 with Sean Penn in it.
Huh.
And it's he's kind of like this troubled youth in the inner city, and gets into trouble, and they've got these little gangs. It's not quite as established gangs as like the Warriors, but there's guys that are up to no good, in this young demographic that are crossing path and clashing with things, and a lot of stuff happens. But it's really Sean Penn gets caught for something and he gets sent to jail, and in the meantime the guy that he had wronged on the outside goes and attacks his girlfriend and stuff like that, and then he gets sent to the same jail. So there's going to be a confrontation, and it's got a bunch of actors like that you've seen before that were all like in really their earliest roles.
Hmm.
You know,
I'll check it out.
It's fantastic. It's a really good movie. It's riveting and doesn't have any kind of special effects or something like that, but shit jumps off and it's exciting as hell to watch. So it's really good. And Sean Penn's he's a great actor. I don't know what's kind of,
because people don't like him because he's obnoxious as hell.
He is obnoxious.
And he's an asshole.
Yeah. But he's been in some stuff and he's done some stuff as an actor. That's like,
he's a good actor, but you know, because he's also an asshole.
What was that movie that he was in with Christopher Walken?
Fast Times at Ridgemont High.
No. It was a very serious one. He was in a movie with Christopher Walken, and I can't remember the title of it. But his Christopher Walken's like the leader of like this kind of crime family that's into stealing and hijacking and shit like that. And his brother was in it too. Who's now deceased? Who was Penn's brother? The one that was in
Owen, was it Owen Wilson? No, he's not dead.
No. His brother.
Brother.
John Penn's brother.
Yeah.
He's kind of heavy set, bigger boy.
I don't know. It's escaping me.
I can't remember, but it's a really good one. And Christopher, it's like a tour de force Christopher Walken performance. I can't remember the fucking name of it, but it's got Sean Penn and Christopher Walken. It's fam at close range. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Call Me Nemo. It's at close range. That movie's fantastic. Have you ever seen it?
No, I haven't seen
it. Fucking check it out, bro. Seriously, you got some work to do. That was a really good one. And it was Chris Penn. Thank you so much, Call Me Nemo. You are so goddamn smart and helpful. We fucking love you, man. Making our show better right there in Twitch. I love it. That's what Twitch should be for. Goddamn. So that's a lot of good stuff. Bad Boys and At Close Range. At Close Range is fantastic. It's riveting. And there's some scenes in there just like the dread and the tension. And there's two actors just going fucking hardcore at each other with Walken and Sean Penn. It's amazing. Pretty cool. Really, really good.
I have to check it out. Put it on the list.
And then I watched a really interesting thing late in the week called The Deadlands, which I found on Amazon Prime. And it's a movie from New Zealand. It's made with the New Zealand Film Corporation and stuff like that. So it's the weirdest goddamn thing I've seen in quite a while. It's very much like, it's almost like a Conan movie.
Okay.
You've got basically like Stone Age type technology level, but it takes place in New Zealand, and it takes place with the Maori people, the native Aboriginal folk of New Zealand. And you know, there's stuff that we've become familiar with New Zealand, thanks to people like The Rock and stuff like that, that do a lot of different things.
He's a
Pacific Islander. Yeah. One of the things that they have a common thread with in New Zealand is the Maori do that haka. That, you know, it's kind of this ritualized dance. It's actually like a battle type thing, a battle type display. And then in this movie, the all the fights have like their own style of fighting. That's almost like a Maori martial art that incorporates this haka into the actual battle.
Pretty neat.
It's really strange because you've got a guy that's basically coming at you, and like they've got these two guys, they're going to face off, they're going to go at each other, and they're doing all these really incredible ritual displays and facial expressions and sticking their tongues out and stuff, and like getting in each other's grill with that first, and then they start getting into close range, and then they kill each other. They fucking literally just go into battle. And they have these clubs that look like ping pong paddles, really strange looking clubs, but you can tell they're like made out of like ivory or jade, some kind of heavy stone, and they've got a sharp edge. So sometimes they'll hit somebody with it and just open their neck up, or they're smashing each other's heads in and stuff with these things. It's a brutal movie. It's really fucking cool. And then there's a character in it that the thing starts out with this young guy who's a member of this tribe. And his dad's a respected leader, and they're, you know, established tribe, and they're going to have this meeting with this other tribe about something, some kind of summit or something like that. And somebody's trying to make war with his tribe. And they find a way to do that. Spoiler warning, wipe out his whole tribe. So he's the only one left, this young guy, the prince of this community, and he manages to escape. And so these guys are all too big and strong, and he's by himself, and he's a pup. He doesn't know how to do anything. And so he's going to go to the Deadlands and summon a demon to come back and help him with his vengeance, which sounds like a perfect setup for a horror movie. And so he goes into these Deadlands, and these guys are also in the Deadlands trying to cross, using it as a shortcut. Big mistake, because there's a guy that lives there in these Deadlands who's the monster of the Deadlands. And it's this character who's very much like Maui from Moana.
Moana, yeah.
Very, very, I mean, like literally like he looks like him. He's got the same kind of hairstyle, big, super strong bear of a guy. And he's this horror that haunts the woods. And this guy manages to actually do this and get him to help. And he comes with him, and there's some fight scenes in this thing that are just like absolutely incredible. Really quite a movie. So a little off the beaten track, super weird, but really cool and violent and interesting to look at. Check out The Badlands, The Deadlands. I really liked it a lot. Really cool. But watch Close Range first, because that's great. At Close Range, the movie.
It sounds really good too.
Yeah. No, it was really cool. It was interesting. I wasn't expecting a whole lot. And you can tell that the budget's not much, because they're just literally they're filming out in the wilds in all these beautiful places in New Zealand and stuff. Just kind of go out in the woods and shoot, because that's where they lived. So they didn't have anything big in scenery or anything like that. But the performances are really good. The fighting stuff is really good. Everything, you know, it's a really well put together movie for, didn't look like an awful lot of dough, but they really wrote an interesting story, and it all plays out really well through the course of the deal.
Sounds awesome.
Yeah. So I like that. So here we go. Time for the weekly book report. What did you learn about this week, my love?
I did not have time to watch much. I had to stay current on the stuff I was watching. That Undoing show on HBO finished and was really good. It's got Nicole Kidman and Hugh Grant, and there's a murder in it, and it was really good. It's kind of like in the vein of Big Little Lies, that type of thing. Kind of a chick show, I guess. I don't know. But it was good. Britannia, I still do not understand what in the heck is going on that show. But I'm hoping it's about to finish the season because it's a lot. I do not understand.
Do you like it still?
Yeah, it's weird enough that I like it because it's, you know, it's kind of supposed to be, you know, early AD England, but it's weird. But there was some new docuseries I saw on the Reagans. It came up on my suggested thing, so I started watching that. There were like 3 episodes about the Reagans.
I like the name of the Reagans.
Yeah, and it was interesting because I don't, you know, remember that stuff really from then because, you know, I was like 10 or whatever.
Yeah, your kids, it's hard, yeah. 10,
yeah, 7 when he got elected, but, you know, it's interesting because a lot of the Reagan stuff, the stuff he said, it's like Trump has like kind of tried to imitate.
Do again.
And do again. And it was just kind of like, oh, because it was like there was a part where he's talking and he was talking about making America great again. I was like, oh, what? And I was like, okay.
You know what? Reagan should sue him.
Right?
From the grave.
Right?
Giuliani could represent him.
Oh, yeah, he could totally.
Oh, my gosh. That's right. We got to do that thing.
What?
I don't know. What, did you take the ballot somewhere? Did you take those ballots somewhere?
You should have done that with 3 employees.
I don't know.
Should take them someplace and do something crazy?
Do something crazy to them? Did you take those ballots somewhere?
Did you take them somewhere?
Did you take them? Do something crazy to them?
Would you something naughty?
Something.
That was.
Do something to them?
Something maybe a little dirty.
A little dirty?
A little something to them?
Well, all I know is I had to sign a thing that if, you know.
If I tell any lies,
I go to jail. Did you?
Did you?
Did you?
Did you?
What'd you do with those ballots?
What'd you do with those ballots?
Fucking crazy.
Do something crazy to him.
Okay. Well, Matt only had 70 hours for this show this week, so I think we need to let him go.
Bad. I wanted to get into the other stuff, too.
Oh, yeah. Okay, spoiler warning.
Okay, all right, go. Shit. Go. All right, so spoiler warning.
Spoiler warning.
Run. Spoiler warning. Run.
You guys can get into the spoilers, so.
All right. Get out. Okay,
Thanks for having me, folks.
Already had your stuff. Okay, so here it is.
Oh, all right, my God.
Mandalorian. Holy shit. Fucking.
All right, I gotta run. I'm not listening.
Holy goddamn what?
Like, yeah.
Bye. I gotta run.
You gotta go. Okay.
Yeah. Unfortunately, but you guys can do the spoilers, so.
We're gonna do the spoilers. Thank you so much for joining us this week.
Well, thanks for having me, dude. We'll see you guys later. Have a great night, day, whatever the fuck.
We will. We're going to have all that. A good day and a night.
All right. Sorry, I got to go.
So, we love you. Thank you for being here.
Hey, thanks for having me. You guys have a great day. Thanks for listening, everybody.
We'll see you in 5 minutes on Twitter now. We're going to
We're going to talk about Matt.
No.
Bye. Okay. We'll see you later, man.
All right, see ya.
No, we'll talk about Matt's hoard.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. All right. See ya.
Arrivederci. Bye. Okay, so... Mando, Lorian, holy shit.
Oh my gosh.
So, you know, you've always had a problem with
I have always had a problem with Boba Fett because it was like as soon as he showed up in Empire Strikes Back, everybody's like, oh,
he's the coolest. He's so mysterious.
He's the coolest ever. Oh, he's a bounty hunter. He's so amazing. And I'm like, what does he do? He doesn't do anything. He stands there next to Darth Vader.
Looks cool. He does look cool.
What does he do on Cloud City?
Stand around.
Stands there next to Darth Vader. You know, maybe he tries to shoot his gun some, but ooh, yeah.
He tried to shoot Luke.
But did he hit him?
No.
And yeah. And then it's like, ooh, Return of the Jedi. I mean, talk about being punked. I mean, it's like he gets his little rocket thing messed up and he flies into the thing and goes into the Sarlacc. Bye-bye. And then it's like he was marginally cool in Dark Empire, the comics,
okay.
When he shows up and with the bounty hunters and is still trying to go after Han and Leia and stuff. So he was marginally cool then. But C wasn't badass or anything because it was like, oh, it's Boba Fett because he's so lame in the movies. But holy crap!
Yeah, he was good in The Mandalorian.
Who knew that all this time he could kick Sirius' ass?
Right.
I mean, major ass.
Yeah, he was just ruining some dudes. Yeah, he's fucking them stormtroopers up, man. I like seeing that plastoid armor flying in fragments all over the place.
Oh my gosh!
It was awesome.
He was smacking them and bits of armor was just oh my gosh!
Well, and it's a good
thing. It was a lot!
It's a good thing he got his armor when he did.
Yes. Well, because, although it probably would have been okay because it's Beskar.
Well, I mean, just the Beskar probably would have been okay, but everything else, I mean, it's not just Beskar. You've got some framework there and that goes into that. You don't just stick a piece of Beskar on your armor.
Yeah, because RIP Razor Crest.
By Razor Crest.
What the heck?
Fucking crater fire.
Mando had a bad day.
Yeah, it's like he had to see it get blowed up, too.
Yeah.
Yeah, and the knee rockets. Holy shit.
Knee rockets!
What? Fire! Holy shit.
Because everybody was always like, oh, he's got knee rockets. I'm like, he doesn't use knee
I can't tell you how
rockets.
Many times I saw that, like, on a
part
little
of his
thing.
Costume. It's part of his outfit.
It's a little bulletproof, bullet through the line going knee rockets right to his little knees right there, some little thing there. And you're like, yeah, okay, whatever. I can accept that because I'm never going to see it happen. It fucking happened. That was incredible.
That was ridiculous.
Yeah, knee rockets were fucking amazing.
Oh, my gosh. I mean, it was like everything that was lame about Boba Fett's potential, like, they used it. Because he kicked people's ass. He just, was shooting things left and right. He was beating people up, shooting knee rockets.
Well, he definitely proved that he should have that armor. Because, fuck yeah, as soon as he got it, shit was fucking on.
Yeah.
He was wrecking some dudes.
Well, I mean, and then, like, that episode.
He was wrecking
like,
dudes before that, and then he got the armor, and he just crushed them even
worse. The episode, it came on and it was like the titles, the tragedy, and and we're both you're like, oh, is it going to be about the tragedy of Darth Plagueis the Wise? and then little did we know it was going to be a tragedy.
Yes, it was, because they took baby.
They took the baby.
They took baby Yoda.
Dark troopers took the baby.
Dark troopers are fucking awesome. I was howling when those things came dropping out of the ship.
He lost his mind.
And they're flying to him like, that's fucking amazing. That's literally what I did. It was crazy.
That was just, the dark troopers. And they took the baby. And like, what the heck was that thing even doing to the baby? Because it's like Mando was trying to be like, okay, we need to go, and like he got knocked back and knocked out for a few minutes while all kinds of stuff is going crazy. And Boba Fett, destroying people with his thing. And
he's on this stone. And then there's column shaped thing of force that's going
force
up into the sky
something.
With little runes and shit in it too, and
all
kinds of weird stuff. So there was something going out into space to somebody, and he seemed pretty satisfied with his efforts. And then boom, here come the bat, and of course he's always
always gets so sleepy because he's a baby.
He's a baby. Really small battery, and he needed a nap.
He needed a nap after that, and that's when the dark troopers came and got him.
Yeah,
and took him up to the Star Destroyer, and then Moff Gideon puts him in a little cell, and then he's freaking using the dark side.
Yeah. So then
and then it's like, who taught him that shit?
Well, it was funny because I don't think taught him that, but he was doing it. And then Moff Gideon's like, oh, no. Let him go ahead. Yeah.
Because he was force choking stormtroopers.
Yeah.
And then he like.
Two at a time.
And then like smashed him against the wall and smashed him into each other. And ooh, baby.
He's mean.
That was not good. Nice, and then he put the tiniest little
I know. He's like, put handcuffs. He's like, where the fuck am I supposed to get handcuffs for that thing? It's like it's 6 inches tall. What the hell am I supposed to do?
It was the cutest little handcuff things he put on him.
Give me those napkin rings that I got for the wedding gift. Get those napkin rings on them, meld them, hold them together with a zip tie, and there you go. You're good to go, baby Yoda.
Oh my gosh. Yeah, and then they stunned him.
They shot him and stunned him.
That was not cool. That was not nice. I don't think that Moff Gideon is a nice guy.
No, he's not. And they're up to no good, but wow.
And then he was like, ooh, have you seen this dark saber? Ooh.
Yeah, and then Baby Yoda's kind of like, he was kind of like force reaching for it. And he's like, oh, no, no, no.
Yeah, he's mean.
Yeah, he's mean to Baby Yoda.
He's mean. But then I saw something somewhere that it's like, man, the Mandalorian is basically every week Mando makes a new best friend.
Yeah.
Because the Razor Crest's gone, but now apparently Boba Fett and Fennec Shan.
Right, who's somehow alive.
Well, because somehow Boba Fett fixed her. From dying?
What the fuck was that? Dead. Yeah, she holds up something like on her midriff, and that explains everything. It's like, I got robot parts now. It's all good.
So, like, Boba Fett, he's not only a badass, he's also some kind of special doctor, major healer guy that can fix people?
Yeah.
How did that happen? They were out there on Tatooine. It's just a bunch of sand. What the heck,
he rubbed some dirt on it. He rubbed some dirt on it. You're fine. Get up.
Yeah, so you got Boba Fett and Fennec Shand, you know, and it's like Razor Crest blown up, and then you're like, oh, well, they're going to fly off, and then Boba's like, well, no, actually, you know, now I owe you a debt, because, you know, I got my stuff back.
Yeah, they're all like, well, it's time for us to go, and he's kind of like, I don't have a ride, guys.
But no.
Help a brother out, and they're like, yes, we can.
Yeah, we have to help you out now.
Well, when I saw the Slave One come in.
When Slave One first showed up.
Wow, we were just like,
oh my God.
Holy fucking shit. Oh my gosh. It's happening.
It's happening.
It's happening. Boba Fett's cool now. Oh my God.
That was bonkers. It was just a lot.
Well, I'm really happy that you're not working on Fridays now, so we can like watch it before. Because somebody, Boba Fett was trending. Boba Fett was trending.
But then again, it's like, you know, I went and I saw Boba Fett was trending, and in my head, I'm like, ugh, Boba Fett's trending. Great. He'll show up and want his armor. Cool. Holy shit.
Yeah, you kind of came around to Boba Fett. So
I'm sorry, Boba Fett. I apologize.
Well, Matt has the coolest horde in the world. Yeah. I think everybody was like, oh, shit, Boba Fett.
I did not realize you were just like holding back from your badassness.
Well, it's kind of funny too. It didn't feel like the armor didn't fit him so well anymore. It was a little grown a little bit as an older fellow.
You know, he was out there in the desert. You know, he had to do what he had to do. He was probably eating. You know, I don't know what there's out there in the desert, but you know, he had some snacks.
So you think that the desert diet's super fattening?
I guess. I don't know.
It's those eggs.
Yes.
He's constantly eating those eggs. Those incredible edible giant.
Yeah, they're like mudhorn eggs or something. They're very fattening.
Yeah, that is weird. Yeah. Ms. Rebecca, she's reflecting on the flight pattern of Slave One, which is odd. And a lot of people really haven't seen much of it unless you played video games. But it is weird because
it does fly weird.
Yeah. You take off laying on your back and then it kind of stands up and you're like kind of like, I'm flying this way now. Oh, it's weird. He's standing up.
How about when Boba shows up and he, you know, said the line and we're just like, oh my God, she said the line.
Yeah, I'm just a simple man trying to make my way in the universe. Much like my dad did. He always said that.
Yeah, we were just my God, she said the line. It was a lot.
Mr. Mecca said he eats a lot of bantha blubber.
It's probably very fattening.
Mm.
But he wasn't, you know, that out of shape that he couldn't kick those stormtroopers. No, he kicked some ass. And how about those stormtroopers?
Yeah, stormtroopers were surprisingly good.
The stormtroopers, I mean, their aim was pretty good.
Yeah, I was scared of them. And they moved fast, yes. and they came right in and stormed on in.
Yes, they were actually stormtroopery because they just came in and just were running all over the place and shooting and doing stuff and just, you know... Probably because they didn't want to piss off Moff Gideon, because who knows what the heck he'd do to him.
Well, it was cool to see what a gaffy stick would be really good on armor like that, too, with that
who
little
knew?
Pokey thing. They used to make those maces and stuff that they used to make in the you know, the yeah. night time of the knights. Those were to puncture armor.
Yeah.
It's like, yeah, I'm, you know, you're going to take a blow, but if the spike goes through,
stuff,
I'm guessing. Yeah.
That was... Wow.
It was wild. Yeah, he was busting them up pretty bad. Wow. Fucking those dudes up. And it's like, oh man, goddamn, now you're gonna have to assault a Star Destroyer.
Yeah,
It's a cruiser, I guess. I don't think it's a Star Destroyer.
Yeah, look, I think they call it a cruiser. But and then it's like, and now he's going to try and go, he's got to break out Mayfield. And I'm just like, really? Mayfield is going to be the one to help you get on there?
Yeah, why does he need him?
I don't know. He's annoying.
Yeah. Well, one other thing that we talked about just before bed last night was apparently there's some mystery surrounding who's directing the final episode. Ooh. We know that the screenplay is by Favreau, but they have not revealed who the director of that episode is going
to
be.
Because they've, you know, everybody's kind of been able to figure out. Everybody figured, you know, that Ahsoka was going to show up in the Filoni directed episode. And then like this episode this week was Robert Rodriguez. And then like the one that had those icky ice spider things, that was the Ant-Man director.
Okay.
So it's like people, you know, it's like it's kind of matched kind of what they're known for or what they've had a little skill set for. So obviously it's something that if we know who it is, we'll kind of have an idea of what's going to go down. But who knows who the heck is going to show up? I mean, somehow they managed to take anything and just make it badass.
Right. Everything that's in the show works better and shows more and makes it cooler. Yeah. I mean, the biker scout drop and Boba Fett is fucking amazing. Everything they put in there just works better. And
Tusken Raiders.
Yeah, they make all of it better.
Crate dragons. It's wild.
Yeah.
Something
to see.
Yeah.
Something to see.
Just, you know, whatever they're planning to do, you know, with the Cassian show, which apparently they started filming.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Well, they're going to start shooting Obi-Wan.
They're going to shoot Obi-Wan earlier. It was going to be March, and now it's apparently January they're going to start shooting.
I wonder
if the things are going to start connecting.
There's some big shit, and it is going to start connecting, I guarantee. I feel like I heard somebody say something about Feige was involved with this branch now of the Disney-owned universes.
That's right.
And if that's the case, I feel like they are using the Marvel method again, to build, here's a thing, and then boom, we're going to build it into some kind of big fucking awesome
and then you're
mashup.
Like, oh my gosh, I didn't realize all that stuff was going to connect in the first place, because, you know, that's what they did with the Marvel movies.
Right.
If they've got him involved.
They've got this whole Mando universe fleshed out so beautifully that they're really going to have to be careful about, not having stuff from the movies later or things from the things later fuck this up.
Do we even need movies later, man?
I don't know. I could deal with this kind of, you know, shared universe.
I mean, if we get this type of a quality, you know, in a TV show,
well, especially,
do we even need it on the movies?
Especially in light of the fact that streaming now seems to be going to be more important. It's going to be more and more important when Warner has taken their entire slate for next year and said it's all going to be on HBO Max. If you have HBO Max next year, you're going to be able to watch basically every new release
on release day.
So all those movies are all going to be there.
It would be great to see things in a movie theater.
Again,
because
we like the big screen and the audio and the
sound and the experience, and then you know the group, you know, reaction
audience,
to things,
right.
The audience. Because granted, you know, we have a pretty good audience here. We're good about that, but you know, lots of people together. You know, like those fight scenes and stuff with Infinity War and Endgame. That was just amazing.
And the energy get really fucked. And the whole audience goes nuts.
So, you know, we'd love that one day, but, you know, it's great that they've decided, you know what, we're just going to build this in, so who knows what happens next year, so we're just already going to say, you're already going to see this stuff on your TV at home if you want to.
No, I you know, and I'm...
And could you imagine if by October we're actually able to go to the movie theater and see Dune on the big screen?
I want to so bad.
And then
I'm gonna
come home and watch it again on HBO Max,
dude,
like
seriously,
15 times.
God, guess what I'm going to do the entire fucking month of November is watch fucking Dune. Because it's October 31st, I think, is when it's supposed to come out.
It's earlier than that.
Maybe. I don't know. But when it's on, I'm going to be watching the shit out of that. It better be good.
Well, it's got your... Timothy Chalamet.
It does. You know what? I go, oh, it better be good. I watched the 1984 one over and over and over again, and it is a famous piece of shit.
Yeah.
So I'm going to watch it. So it's interesting to see what they're doing with the Mandalorian and really building that universe out.
It could be cool to see, you know, stuff like that's happened in the Mandalorian on a big screen with audience reaction and everything. But if we don't get that and we just get this quality of story and lore and effects and acting and everything, okay, I'll take it.
No, it's good.
Because it's amazing what they've done.
No problem.
And I still get blown away that they're not actually out in the desert somewhere.
Right, that volume thing is amazing.
My mind still cannot comprehend that they're just on this like stage thing with some weird projecty thing. It's just like sorcery. What the heck, man?
It's not that complicated.
Yes, it is.
No, it's not. Well, I mean, it is because they just invented it. But
it's bonkers. And it's so good. And probably now they've realized they can do
anything
with it. The level of Star Wars-ness they can do with that. Wow.
Yeah. Well, they're giving us a lot of and we I forgot the Boba Fett missile. Missile firing Boba Fett. Oh my god, that's the fucking most, you know, I mean, it's like the legend of action figures, missile firing Boba Fett. Here's Boba Fett. Watch me shoot a fucking missile and take down an entire fucking transport that crashes into the other one. And he goes, I was aiming for the other one. So good.
And who knew he could actually do a quip?
Yeah, he quipped.
He quipped. Again, Boba Fett, I apologize. I apologize.
Well,
it was definitely
a reassessment for The Mandalorian, too, to see a guy with armor that he's completely off what he thought a Mandalorian was going out into the greater world, how he was so insulated for so long. He's gotten a lot of eye openers in the last few episodes about what's up with Mandalorians and their armor and stuff. And he thought he was full on a Mandalorian.
Well, and then it kind of added to Boba Fett and Jango because Jango was a foundling. Right.
Yeah.
So it's just like, what?
Yeah.
Does this mean
they're making everything cooler? They're making Jango Fett cooler.
Does this mean we can't make fun of Jango Flexions anymore?
Yes, we still can.
We still can.
We still will.
The other Flexions are so better than that freaking Jango, but it kind of makes Jango a little cooler too.
Yeah.
Because he was a foundling, and it was the same thing. And wow.
So, the reason I mentioned the thing about not knowing who the director for the last episode is because whispers in the wind, rumor I heard, probably bullshit, maybe not happen, that the last episode of the season is going to be directed by George Lucas, which is possible since we saw him on set when they were filming Ahsoka. He's been around during filming times, so it's entirely possible that would happen. And it would be amazing. That would be an amazing thing. If he came back and directed an episode of Mando for like TV scale or something like that, just to go in and do it.
Just to be part of it.
Yeah, that would be amazing. I think that people would really love that.
Huh.
So we'll see. It's coming fast, unfortunately. The episode, you know, the season's not very long.
Well, yeah, and there's no telling who out there sensed Grogu.
Right. We don't have any. I don't feel like the Mandalorian is going into the battle with the space cruiser and them alone. I think somebody's going to show up. There's a big oh shit moment coming beyond Ahsoka yet.
You think?
Yeah. I do.
Huh.
I don't know what it's going to be, but I think they're going to hit us with something big at the end.
Yeah, because Thrawn is out there and Ezra's out there somewhere.
Right. Well, I mean, look at our reactions to these episodes. We're watching these episodes and we're howling at the television.
Oh, yeah.
We're literally shrieking out loud at the television. No fucking way. We're yelling at the TV.
Routinely yelling at the TV.
Anything can happen. And they're just.
Yep. Sabine is out there too.
Yeah.
Yep.
They're not fucking around. So
Luke is out there. Luke is out there.
Cal Kestis? Is that who you're hoping for? Qui-Gon Jinn and Tonic? Kestis?
No. Even though, I mean, they have the actor, but, you know, for Luke, they can get, what's his name that looks like young Luke? Sebastian Stan.
I've seen that mentioned.
They have available because he's working on Falcon and Winter Soldier.
That would be amazing if they did do something with Luke and Sebastian Stan as Luke. That would be amazing because he really does look like.
Like, where does Grogu end up at, like, at the end game of all this?
Well, we used to joke, you know, that he was.
Is he going to show up and is he going to go to Luke's little bunch of people, little training people, and then does Kylo Ren kill Grogu?
That'd be horrible. I don't know if you could redeem. I don't know if you could possibly redeem.
They would make Kylo really bad then.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. How do you redeem Kylo from having killed Grogu?
But you know what? He probably wouldn't, because, you know, he'd probably slip away just like he managed to slip away in the temple from Anakin.
Mm.
That's what he does. He just, you know.
He just slips away.
Slips away from murdering Skywalkers. So, you know, maybe.
Here's hoping.
Which, that would be crazy if we got to see more of that at some point.
A little flashback.
Of Luke's temple thing getting destroyed. And, you know, the original temple getting destroyed. Ooh.
Ah.
Ah.
Yeah. Well, there's a lot of ground to cover. They're not going to give us everything, but they've given us so much already. So I got no complaints.
Yep.
No complaints.
So good.
So.
Just so good.
So anything else? Did we miss anything?
No.
Okay, let's
just be done. Just again, I apologize, Boba Fett.
She didn't know.
I didn't know.
Well, folks, we hope you know more than you did when you started this show. We hope you enjoyed it. We thank you so much for tuning in and listening. We thank all our friends on Twitch today. We got up to 10 today on Twitch.
Ooh.
So that was fantastic. Thank you
much. Hello, everyone.
And thank you so much to everybody on Twitch for contributing, too. So helpful to have people to just answer questions and make the show better. Really enjoy that. That's really cool. So we look forward to seeing you again next week. And arrivederci.
Bye.
We are Legion.
We are all.
We are one.
We are
watching.
We are one.